Hey everyone, we want to welcome you and say happy Thanksgiving. And listen, we're in a season where we're looking at our communities rebuilding. And as you're celebrating Thanksgiving right now, I just want to remind you this is a special time that there's precious praise that we get to lift to Jesus today that's unique because it's in the time of brokenness. We're not going to have this time in heaven. This is time that's reserved for these moments that the God of the universe would be lifted up with praise from hearts that are hurting, from hearts that are looking for hope. And our heart is that as we worship, that God's presence, He's going to be here, He's here with us, and that He's going to fill your room, your home right now. And we want you to know that He's enough for you today. So let's welcome Him. God, we ask that you would fill this time. Lord, as we worship, we do so declaring that you are our hope. Lord, with thanksgiving and with praise, we look to you and we say, God, be exalted in our lives. We lift our praise to you and we say, Jesus, you are more than enough in every season, and we worship you now.
Oh, you've seen your faithfulness. I've seen it in my life, in my family and my friends. I've seen them come through time after time, time after time. He won't change now.
Song to
summer and winter, springtime.
all of my duplicity. Now there is no record. You assume the best of me. This is why. And this is why I thank the Lord for saving me when I was weak. So I will sing. This is why I thank the Lord for everything. This is why I thank the Lord. All of my affection, everything I have to give, the sum of my attention is measured in the praise I lift up. This is how I thank the Lord for saving me when I was weak. So I will sing. This is how I thank the Lord for everything. This is how I thank the Lord. This is how. This is how I thank the Lord for loving me and keeping me. So I will sing. This is how I thank the Lord for everything. This is how I thank. Come on, this is how we thank.
By G.K. Chesterton that says that thankfulness is the highest form of thought. He says that gratitude is happiness multiplied with wonder. And there's this special place that our hearts go to when we choose to be thankful in circumstances where it looks like it's hard to be thankful. Revelation records in chapter 4 that God is surrounded, and there's angels that circle him, and they say, holy, holy, holy. And they worship, and they never leave this place of gratitude and thankfulness and wonder at who he is. And I just want to say a couple of things because we're directed to live this way in Scripture. Hebrews says this in chapter 13, "Let us therefore offer through Jesus a continual sacrifice of praise." A continual sacrifice of praise. So what does that look like? What does it look like to continually offer praise? Well, I just want you to know that when we choose to live and to have moments like we're having right now, those praises don't stop. They continue when they leave our mouths and they leave our hearts. And when we choose and we say, "Soul, I don't feel like it, and it doesn't feel like I can do this, but I choose to praise God. God, I praise you. I worship you." And when we make that decision, those praises don't stop. They continue. We join with angels that don't stop. We join with what happens in heaven that never stops. And the wonder of God and the gift of God and the unfailing love of God meets us. And we join our praises with heaven. It's amazing because it reminds us that every plan of the enemy, every hard time that we walk through, every recovery that is in front of us from a hurricane, it has a time stamp. Like, it's going to come to an end. You're in a physical battle, it's going to come to an end. You're trying to rebuild your life after losing everything, it's going to come to an end. Every plan of the enemy has a time stamp to it. But when we choose to praise, it reminds our soul that we are His and there is no time stamp on His unfailing love. His plans don't have a time stamp. They don't stop. We're in His hands. David said this. He said, "Praise the Lord," in Psalm 113. "Yes, give praise, O servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord now and forever. Everywhere from east to west, praise the name of the Lord." This is the eternal place that we've been invited to, praising our God, whose plans never end, His purposes don't run out. And so right where you're at, would you just lift your hands? I'm going to pray and just ask God to remind us that when present circumstances speak so loud, I'm asking the Holy Spirit to remind us that we're still His, that every hardship has a time stamp to it. But the unfailing love of the Lord never ceases, and we're His. So God, right now, oh, thank you that you meet us in these moments and we get to join and unite praise with heaven. Yeah. We get to unite praise and our souls and our hearts are reminded that God, every plan of the enemy has a time stamp. It will come to an end in our life, but your purpose and your plan never will. You outlast every plan of the enemy. Lord, those plans fall and they fail. And your purpose and your plan happens in our life and it succeeds and it rules and it reigns. And there's no time stamp to it. And so God, right now, I ask that you would strengthen every heart. Lord, on this day that we choose to live thanksgiving and we choose to live praise, God, would you speak to every heart, comfort, remind them that they are yours. And Lord, we worship you. We say, we join with the angels and we say, "Holy, holy, holy, there's no one like you." And we worship and we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Lift our eyes to you, Jesus. Lift your head, lift your eyes, look to the sun. In the test, in the trial, His grace is enough. His grace is enough. Yeah. And oh my soul, remember who you're singing to. Take heart, hold on, remember who you're singing to. He's still the Lord Almighty, he's still the King of Kings, he's still the risen Savior reigning over everything. His name is still the